451, this one, Rhythm of the Road. First world with a third world. Third world with a first world sound, I should say. I mean, kind of phrase it, see?
Cosmic harmony, universal love, you can get it for free. Get cosmic harmony. Universal love, you can get it for free. Can't stop moving, rhythm of the room. Say you can't stop moving, the rhythm of the room. Can't stop moving, the rhythm of the room.
For you.
Title track from the album Committed. Third world with the first world song. Yes. Alright. Committed. Yeah. Reggae Vibration on WHCR 90.3 FM New York. Yeah. Committed. Alright. Reggae Vibrations. Mm-hmm. Alright. Yeah. Okay, alright. Yes, indeed. Uh-huh.
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Help in the fight against violence at the third...
When the roll is called out, I'll be standing taller to face the darkest and the hardest of time.
Yeah, Queen Africa.
We'll be taking care of all the children.
All right. 5 o'clock,
but if it's required, we'll be on the
Lioness on the rise.
You can call me by my name. I am ready to roll. Once the rules remain the same, how the story is. Call me anytime, never cop out. Lioness is on the rise, don't you ever have doubt. Never say never, willingness forever to fight and be strong. Once it's for better, I'll write every letter and moving right along. And I'll roll with the punches, accept changes. Work with the formula, do what I have to do, and call me by my name. I am ready to roll. Once the rules remain the same, how the story's been told. Call me anytime, never cop out. Lioness is on the rise, don't you ever have doubt. When you are willing to serve, we have room to observe, to see if you can walk the walk you took. Let me give you my word, my voice must be heard. Bravery is a beat of my heart. Call me by my name, I am ready to roll. Once the rules remain the same, how the story's been told. A lioness is on the rise. Don't ever have no doubt. When the roll is called up, we'll be standing taller to face the darkest and the hardest of time. We'll be taking care of all the children thereof. But if it's required, we'll be on the front line. You can call me by my name. I am ready to roll. Once the rules remain the same, how the story's been told.
How is the chop back?
To the world.
I mean, music was for life, you know. I went and beg my friend from the enemy. I said, Selassie, I praise and born to be there.
Haile Selassie, I never lose a fight yet. Like how the sun never witness the night yet. Darkness never overcome light yet. And the wicked never saw no good seed arrive yet. You never see Haile Selassie, I hype yet. And the man never big up wrongs override yet. Babylon set them up the vision, but them not sight it. But if I credit card, them ready to go swipe it. So me say, you're the ease of forever hold your peace. The lioness shall overcome, blessed is the mix. So me say, I scan the microchip, them a release. I don't you see you're in the belly of the beast. So me say, Rastafari shall set the people free. Free all you want to, free all you want to be. Over land and distance, I and overseas. Free all you want to, free all you want to. Babylon and my sister, my cousin, my brother, we're unrelated. And them associate with them are obligated. And them war of aggression with them dominate with. High society, new technology system navigated. Computer world, them facilitated. AK-47, them assassinated. The lion and tribe of Judah, them no one fist stand with. They only come to show us hatred. Then I saw the rights of the people get manipulated. And from the simple things, them better isolated. If you know the guilt, try then why you hesitated. One sound from the ghetto, them eliminated. Then
you're the east and forever hold your peace. The lioness shall overcome, blessed is the weak. So I said, I scan the microchip, them a release. I don't you know you're in the belly of the beast. So me say tumble them, tumble them, tumble them, tumble them, tumble them for real. And I'm the bingy one to one and use a busy seal. Yeah. Pull round no corner cause we not go make no deal. From your just take all the side with light fire and your heel.
Say I see I never lose a fight yet. Like how the sun never witness the night yet. Darkness never overcome light yet. And the wicked never sow a good seed we ripe yet. You never see I listen to see how you hype yet. And the man never big up wrongs over right yet. Babylon set them up the vision, but them not sight it. But if I credit card, them ready fi go swipe it. So me say,
and the east of forever hold the peace. The lioness shall overcome, blessed is the meek. So me say, I scan the microchip, them a release. I don't you know you're in the belly of the beast. So me say,
Rastafari shall set the paper free.
Free all you want to, free all you want to be.
Over land and distance, I and overseeing.
Free all you want to, free all you want to.
Babylon and my sister, my cousin, my brother, we're unrelated. And them associate with them are obligated. And them war of aggression with them dominate with. High society, new technology system navigated. Computer world, them fascinated. AK-47, them assassinate with. The lion tribe of Judah, them no one fist stand with. They only come to show us hatred. Then I saw the rights of the people get manipulated. And from the simple things, them better isolated. If you know the gate, we fly. Then why you hesitated? One sound from the ghetto, them eliminated. Them
you're this and forever hold your peace. The lioness shall overcome. Blessed is the mix. I'm missing. I scan the microchip, them a release. I don't you know you're in the belly of the mix. I'm missing. Tumble them, tumble them, tumble them, tumble them, tumble them.
You got to make it better for the youths, them future, and we can't sit and go on like when I say something kind of go wrong still. And we don't talk it out before the children fail.
To the world again. You feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Don't bring it to Jamaica, keep it to yourself. We no want that a jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness. You can't change the laws of man, but you can't change the laws of God. So if they not, not enough because they glad. And if you change a pussy, man, them mad somebody. Tell me what is happening. I don't want no fishing on me, I tell this to see my son become a father. I'm a greatest wish. The situation kind of very ticklish. But everybody fed up from parish to parish. Yes, and to whom it may concern. I know that the way we want the tables to turn. As a citizen, we got a lot of concern. The truth is, I know that we want with children them to learn. If you feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Don't bring it to Jamaica and keep it to yourself. We no want that
jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness, hear this, you be
multiplying,
you replenish the earth. And that's why you're the woman labor in a childbirth. Me now want to see me brother dress up in a no skirt, and me sister no fi make that actually for faster. As a nation, no matter what we put God first, if we think I see a teen, it's a blessing, not a curse. Lightning and thunder won't fi make the cloud burst. And just the water from the sugar cane can quench any thirst. To whom it may concern, another day we want the tables return.
As a citizen, we have a lot of concern.
The truth is another that we want with children, them
feel. If you feel,
you feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself.
We don't bring it to Jamaica,
keep it to yourself.
We don't want that a jam rock,
keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness.
Hear this. Man, but you can't change the laws of Jah.
So if they're not, nothing not because they're glad. And if you change, I must see mad, they mad. Somebody tell me what is happening. I don't want no fish in me eyes and dish to see my son become a father. I'm a greatest wish. The situation kind of very ticklish. But everybody fed up from parish to parish. Yes, and to whom it may concern. I know that the way we want the tables return. As a citizen, we got a lot of concern. The truth is, I know that we want with children them filler. If you feel like a Batman, keep it to yourself. Don't bring it to Jamaica, keep it to yourself. We no want that a jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness.
You got to make,
you got to make it better.
Yeah. Queen Africa.
We can't sit and go on like when I say something kind of wrong still. We don't talk about it.
To the world again. You feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Don't bring it to Jamaica, keep it to yourself. We no want that a jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness. You can't change the laws of man, but you can't change the laws of God. So if they're not, nothing not because they're glad. If you change, I must see mad, they mad. Somebody tell me what is happening. I do want no fish in me eyes and dish to see my son become a father. I'm a greatest wish. The situation kind of very ticklish. But everybody fed up from parish to parish.
Five, so 12, yeah. As I
said, we want the tables return.
As a
citizen, we got a lot of
concern.
The truth is, I know that we want with children them filler. If you feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Bring it to Jamaica and keep it to yourself.
We don't want that a jam rock.
Keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness. Hear this, you be multiply and replenish the earth. And that's why you're the woman labor in a childbirth. Me no want to see me brother dress up in a no skirt. And me sister no fi make that actually for pastor. As a nation, no matter what we put God first. If we think I see a teen, it's a blessing, not a curse. Lightning and thunder won't fi make the cloud burst. And just the water from the sugar cane can quench any thirst. To whom it may concern, another day we'll be on the tables return. As a citizen, we got a lot of concern. The truth is, another that we want with children, them feel. You feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Don't bring it to Jamaica, keep it to yourself. We no want that a jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness. You can't change the laws of man, but you can't change the laws of God. So if they're not, nothing not because they're glad. If you change, I must see mad, they mad. Somebody tell me what is happening. I do want no fish in me eyes and dish to see my son become a father. I'm a greatest wish. The situation kind of very ticklish. But everybody fed up from parish to parish. Yes, and to whom it may concern. I know that the way we want the tables.
530 mega vibration, see?
The truth is, I know that we want with children them feel. If you feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Bring it to Jamaica and keep it to yourself. We no want that a jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness. Hear this, you be multiply and replenish the earth. And that's why you're the woman labor in a childbirth. Me no want to see me brother just up in a no skirt. And me sister no fi make that actually for password. As a nation, no matter what we put God first. If we think I see a teen, it's a blessing, not a curse. Lightning and thunder won't fi make the cloud burst. And just the water from the sugar cane can quench any thirst. To whom it may concern, another day we want to
tables we turn. As a citizen, we got a lot of concern. The truth is, I know that we want with children to learn. You feel like a bad man, keep it to yourself. Don't bring it to Jamaica, keep it to yourself. We don't want that a jam rock, keep it to yourself. We can't take no more slackness. You can't change the laws of man, but you can't change the laws of God.
Serious weapon, not too much denomination. Discrimination, confusion, destruction, total devastation.
Calling out the children of Africa. Never let mama fall on her knees. Take her hand, lead her to freedom. You must unite for violence to cease. We must fight, fight for equality. Stand up for
Zimbabwe, South Africa, Ethiopia, no like what I wanna, Somalia, Nigeria to Kenya, stand together, no trad with Gambia, Ivory Coast, Malawi to Mozambique, well, if you Tanzania, no, we can't get weak. Africa, the victory sweet.
Calling out the children of Africa, never let mama fall on her knees. Take her hand, lead her to freedom, you must unite. To see, we must fight, fight for equality, stand up for justice, take to the streets. The motherland is weeping. Yes, it's time for us to trample the knees.
Refugees walking for miles and miles, faces very sad, no there is no smiles. Rebel soldiers raping everything in sight. In the heat of the day or the darkest night, black or kill black, no that is not right. African leaders, no you're losing sight. From out of the darkness walking to the light. Join us together, no make we start united.
Calling out the children of Africa. Never let mama fall on her knees. Take her hand, lead her to freedom. You must unite for violence to cease. We must fight, fight for equality, stand up for justice.
are more than one. A million dead from we nation. Yes, poverty, they said it is the perfect plan. We destroy the mother creation. Religious division, a serious weapon, not too much denomination. Discrimination, confusion, destruction, total devastation.
Calling out the children of Africa. Never let mama fall on her knees. Take her hand, lead her to freedom. You must unite for violence to cease. We must fight, fight for equality. Stand up for justice, take to the streets. The motherland is weeping. Yes, it's time for us to trample the beast.
Congo, Darfur, Zimbabwe, South Africa, Ethiopia, no like what I wanna, Somalia, Nigeria to Kenya, stand together, no trad with Gambia, Ivory Coast, Malawi to Mozambique, we'll defeat Tanzania, no we can't get weak, Africa the victory sweet.
Calling out the children of Africa, never let mama fall on her knees, take her hand, lead her to freedom, you must.
Calling Africa from the Montego Bay album, see? Queen Africa, yeah.
Stand up for justice,
yeah, 521, see?
The motherland is weeping. Yes, it's time for us to trample the
beast. Refugees walking for miles and miles, faces very sad, no, there is no smiles. Rebel soldiers raping everything in sight, in the heat of the day or the darkest night. Kill black, no, that is not right. African leaders, no, you're losing sight. Almost at the darkness, walk into the light. Join us together, no, make we start united.
Calling out the children of Africa. Never let mama fall on her knees.
Yeah.
Take her hand, lead her to freedom. You must unite for violence to cease. We must fight, fight for equality. Justice, take to the streets. The motherland is weeping.
Yes, yeah.
It's time for us to trample the beast.
All right, 522 Reggae Vibration and WHCR 90.3 FM New York. More music after these messages.
New York City Rising Stars Take Charge Basketball Over Violence, held on Saturday, April 6, 2013. The first game begins at 2 p.m. with New York City coaches versus the NYPD All-Stars. The second game will begin at 4 p.m. with New York City's top varsity boys versus celebrities. Basketball Against Violence is a free event and will take place at the City College of New York, located at 160 Convent Avenue in Harlem. For more information, call School Safety Agent Blackwell or Agent Carter at 718-730-8550. That's 718-730-8550.
On Saturday, April 6th and Wednesday, April 10th, Councilman Robert Jackson and the American Italian Cancer Foundation will bring free mammography screenings to the residents of West Harlem and Washington Heights. The service is limited to women 40 years and older who are residents of New York City and have not had a mammography in the last 12 months. Mobile care clinics will be stationed in front of the George Bruce Library at 125th Street and Amsterdam Avenue and New York & Company at 181st and Broadway. If you're eligible for this service, please call 877-628-9090 to schedule an appointment.
Yes, you can be a healthcare professional. It's never too early to think about becoming a doctor, nurse, dentist, or pharmacist. At Mentoring in Medicine's conference, you can meet various experts who will tell you how you can become a healthcare professional and what they do. Mentoring in Medicine's 7th Annual Yes, I Can Be a Healthcare Professional Conference will be held on Saturday, April the 27th from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. The conference will be held at Frederick Douglass Academy, located at 2581 Adam Clayton Powell Jr. Boulevard in Harlem. This event is free and for young people ages 8 to 28. For more information, call 718-920-6626. That's 718-920-6626. Or visit the website www.medicalmentor.org.
On Saturday, April the 20th at 3 p.m., Dr. Ruth Singletary presents the Christian Comedy Show. This fundraiser for the renovation of the World Evangelical Deliverance Center will feature BET's Comic View comedians Gerald Kelly and his son Isaiah Kelly.
I go visit my daughter's teacher. The teacher gets upset that I'm there. Mr. Kelly, I don't know why you're here. She's angelic. She's the reason I teach. This is all her work. My son, I'll be at the house. Hey, man, look, before I go to the school, you want to tell me what they're going to tell me later? No, I don't even know why they want you to come. It's my best year ever. I'm doing my thing. I don't even know.
Also performing will be the Samuel Temple Praise Team. Doors open at 2 p.m. and refreshments will be sold. That's the Christian Comedy Show held on Saturday, April the 20th at 3 p.m. This event will be held at Samuel's Temple, located at 75 East 125th Street between Madison and Park Avenue.
Where the parents, all the parents, make some noise. Where y'all at? Parents, clap. Yeah. All right. I'm tired of y'all, Y'all get on my nerves, man. Y'all buy all this food in the house. Come home, pack the cabinets, pack the refrigerators. Then what y'all tell the kids? Yeah, I ain't buy all this food. Y'all eat it all up. So what you buying for? I'm hungry.
For tickets, call 347-346-8365. That's 347-346-8365. The City College of New York Educational Theater Program presents Family Arts Day, Saturday, April the 27th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Family Arts Day is filled with fun for the whole family. There will be face painting, mask making, clowns, sing-alongs, puppets, live performances, raffle prizes, and more. That's Family Arts Day, Saturday, April the 27th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. This free event will be held at the Aaron Davis Hall, located at 150 Convent Avenue at 135th Street.
All right. Yes. All right. Yeah, touch more of this now. Okay. I've been waiting for something. Lives in the Balance. This one is called by Third World with the First World Sound. Lives in the Balance.
Stone. There are lives in the balance.
no beg no friend. Them say we ethnic. Skidip. Them say we ethnic. Yay. Say we legal and we no take back chat. And we are hardcore and we tough like rock. A boy no pass in place and this to my face. We no play that, no. Oh boy, don't play that, no. There's a pirate, pirate behind every corner, trying to reap what he never sow. Cause we hip to the tricks of the hypocrites. Them don't know, say we know. And when them want get feisty, them link up with name to a posse. Claim say we don't have no mercy, cause we don't take no crap from nobody. I say we legal, and we no take back chat, and we are hardcore, and we tough like rock. I wanna pass in place, and this to my face. We no play that, no. Oh boy, don't play that, no. And we no play that, no. Oh boy, don't play that, no. Show some respect, sir. When you're talking to me, I come direct, sir. Tired of the hypocrisy, you can relax, relax. We'll pay with tax, we'll chill to the max, max. These are the facts. Nobody can push me round. Nobody can push me. Hear me, I say super. Say we legal, and we no take back chat. And we are hardcore, and we tough like rock. Nobody pass in place, and this to me face. Oh no, I will no play that. Oh boy, don't play that, no. How we no play that, no. Oh boy, don't play that, no. They call us ethnic. We not look no friend, we not beg no friend. We are hardcore to the very end. Skid it, hey. Skid it, hey, hey. There's a pirate, pirate behind every corner, trying to reap what he never sow. But we hip to the tricks of the hypocrite, and them don't know, say we know. And when them want to get feisty, then link up with him with a posse. Claim say we don't have no mercy, cause we no take no crap from nobody. You can't push me round, no. You can't keep me down, no. Shadow we're legal, and we no take back chat, and we are hardcore, and we tough like rock. A boy no pass in place, and this do we face. We don't play that, no. Homeboy don't play that, no. And we don't play that, no. Homeboy don't play that, no. You can relax, relax. We'll pay with tax, we'll chill to the max, and these are the facts, facts. Skid it, hey. Now we not look no friend. We are hardcore to the very end. You know me legal, and me no take back chat. And me a hardcore, and me tough like rock. I say me legal, and me no take back chat. Cause we are hardcore, and me tough like rock.
They report it abroad. It's not safe in the nights in a state of siege.
talking about a state of siege. We will go on playing music night and day. We will go on playing music no matter what they say. We will keep on jamming our music till broad daylight. We ain't gonna get mixed up, no, in this here fuss and fight. Hold tight. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Say that I'm a doodle, yes. Oh, my boo-boo, this meeting. The food is a done, but is another shipment a gun come. Most of the people don't steal and plunder, but the wicked have them under a state of siege. Talking about a state of siege. So many innocent in prison every day and night, yeah. In this your state of siege, talking about the state of siege. Yet the wicked ones get away, escaping from your state of siege. Talking about the state of siege. One question. Who warned them of the plan so they can move beforehand, yeah. How did the guilty know it was time to go? Before they dropped the state of siege. Before they dropped the state of siege. We will go on playing the music night and day. We will go on playing music no matter what they say. We will go on jamming music every day. Fuss and fight, hold tight. Whop on them, they don't provoke us. And that's on them, they don't annoy us with their state of siege. Talking about their state of siege. Listen. It hurt them, hold your music, lead us through the state of siege. They lead us through the state of siege. So people stay cool. Don't heat up the water. When jam music rules, no wicked can find no shelter. No, no, from our state of siege. Jaja state of siege. Surround them with music, yeah. In a disya state of siege. Talking about the state of siege. We're going to bombard them with our music. Surround them with our music. Capture them with our music. Judge them with our music.
A man without his faith is like a tree without its roots. Got to be true, you got to be true. Strength and protection, giving unto I, my highly, highly, high. Well, if you don't got no vision, then you're empty inside. Yeah. Oh, it's like a gazing in space, wasting time.
Okay, this is Thomas Riley. The eyesight, this one is called 540.
Yes, you heard.
From third world with the first world sound. Eyes in the balance, illegal and state of siege. Yeah.
King Rastafari, I am eyesight. He's the light in the hour of darkness. King Rastafari, I am the lifeline. Ruling at the heart of all flesh. King Rastafari, I am eyesight. Is the light in the hour of darkness. King Rastafari, I am a lifeline. He rules in the heart of all flesh. Now, wipe away the stress, eliminate the crosses. Oh. Well, I sight the fullness without my glasses. Oh. Defender of the faith, no matter what the class is. Oh, unto I, we give Isaiah. King Rastafari, I am the Isaiah. He's the light, not the hour of darkness. King Rastafari, I am the lifeline. He
dwelling at the heart of all flesh. Keep us afar, I am my eyesight. The light, not the hour of darkness. Rastafari, I am my eyesight. Ruling at the heart of all flesh. All you have is faith, let it keep you while you wait for brighter days to come. Still we're working and we're searching to find happiness under the sun. All you have is faith, let it keep you while you wait for brighter days to come. And every troubled situation like me, I'm in a lion mode. Take time, try it out. Eyesight is the light, not the hour of darkness. Rastafari, I am the lifeline, ruling at the heart of all flesh. Mama, eyesight, him at the light, not the hour of darkness. King Rastafari, I am the lifeline, ruling at the heart of all flesh. Rastafari, I am my eyesight, he's the light, not the hour of darkness. King Rastafari, I am the lifeline, he ruling at the heart of all flesh. Eyesight is like a tree without its roots. Got to be true, you got to be true. And life and protection given unto I by eyesight is like a tree without its roots. Got to be true, you got to be true.
Tell me something I go around. Me have it, you have it.
I got this feeling inside bubbling over. Don't need no Dr. X, I know I need my lover. You can't resist, no escape. The feeling start creeping up, coming your way. Yeah, I do a thing no matter what they say. You find yourself walking around daydreaming. Roses being red and violets blue. She loves me, yeah, she loves me not, that's what you do. You can't get a grip, I know you're acting foolish. Look in the mirror and say, what's this? Looks like something my girl. Love's contagious, something my girl. But it's the sweetest sickness. Feeling inside bubbling over. You get the feeling in the side bubbling over. Look like something my girl. Love's contagious, I don't need to be cured. Woman, you fill my prescription. Feel like a new man. You're like my vitamin, you keep me coming. Oh baby, you're my medicine. Woman, I need you so, never letting you go. And when your love attacked me, I couldn't do a thing about it. No, me no want fish in a pharmacist. No, me just want you to come and treat me. Me no want no doctor come drugs me. No, all me want you do is I diagnose me. Fill me up with all of your good stuff, girl. Fill me up, woman, I'm your patient. And I know it's real. Get hooked, start wonder if them tie you or if it's love push. Symptoms start show, I know you've got the look. It's like she need a medication or she need that joke. Scientists are certifying an antidote. Can't do what them experiment are about. So don't feel guilty like it's a sin. I just the vibes and a regular thing. I look for something my girl. Love's contagious, something my girl. That sickness, feeling inside bubbling over. And all I want is for my lover to come over. It's like something my girl. Love's contagious, something my girl. But just the sweetest sickness, feeling inside bubbling over. Don't need my doctor right, I know I need my lover. Tell us something my girl. Love's contagious, I don't need to be cured. Woman, you fill my prescription. Feel like a new man. You're like my vitamin C. Oh, me, you're my medicine. Woman, I need your soul. Never letting you go. And when your love attacked me, I couldn't do a thing about it. And now, I'm no one fishing a pharmacist. No, I just
just want you to come and treat me. You know I'm a doctor, come drugs me, no. All me want you to is diagnose me. Fill me up with all of your good stuff, girl. Fill me up, woman, I'm your patient. Cause I know it's real.
Cease, Miss Isis, unto His Majesty. Lead my cause, O Rastafari. Fight against those that fight against I and I. Lead my cause, O Rastafari. I, ever living, ever faithful, and ever sure. He's coming from the land of King David. I am stamped and played with 72 nation crown and hail him. When you hail him, hail him high.
Rastafari,
High Majesty, King of kings and the Lord of lords, conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. Like him there's no other. When you hail him high.
Blessia.
And me say, oh, wicked vices, yeah. But the enemy sit and watch and talk, the blessing multiply, yeah. History recall in 1966, what a palace here, does he afford? But if I could get around, this little shot, man, the marks are who da? A King Selassie.
Never before has the world seen a king like him.
His imperial check your culture, so true, ask the elders, it's true.
Sure. Prophet John Marcus said, look to the east for the coming of a black king.
Seen the flashing lightning, watch the wicked frightening. When you hail him, hail him, got to hail him, hail him high. Elect of himself a light of this world. Let to the children, boys and girls, them lust for diamonds and pearls. When you hail him high.
Rastafari, I.
And man's your wicked vices, yeah. While the enemies sit and they watch and they call, the blessing multiply, yeah. Them a talk, some of my son got mad, stop me. I'm them meet a sickle, but they tap each other. When them look on me, shut a dozen button. When me have a oof, a picture. A King Selassie.
Never before has the world seen a king like him.
His imperial power.
Just you.
Live I, far I, Majesty I.
Rastafari. Ever living, ever faithful, and ever sure. Heed my cause, I Rastafari. Fight against those that fight against I and I. Heed my cause, I Rastafari. Ever living, ever faithful, and ever sure. Heed my cause, I Rastafari. Fight against those that fight against I. Heed my cause, I Rastafari. Ever living, ever faithful, ever sure.
I and I, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, elect of God, elect of Himself, Light of this world, Most High Jah, Rastafari. Scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come. And unto him shall the gathering of the children be. All I and I, people, shall be gathered unto the Most High.
I.
Rastafari, Mighty I, Lagos I. Isla I, Jah, Rastafari.
Is unto His Majesty. Heed my cause, or Rastafari. Fight against those that fight against I and I. Heed my cause, or Rastafari. I, ever living, ever faithful, and ever sure. He's coming from the land of King David. A lion's tamed and played with. 72 nation crowned and ailing. When you hail him high.
Rastafari,
High Majesty, King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah. Like him, there's no other. When you hail him high.
Blessie,
I. And myself, devices, yeah. While the enemy sit and watch and talk, the blessing multiply, yeah. History recall in 1966, what a palace here does he afford? A leap a crowd gather round, this little shark man, the marks are who that? A King Selassie. Check your culture, so true. Ask the elders, it's true. Sure. Prophet John Marcus said, look to the east for the coming of a black king. Sing the flashing lightning, watch the wicked frightening. When you hail him, hail him. Got to hail him high. Elect of himself, a light of this world. Let to the children, boys and girls. Them lust for diamonds and pearls. When you hail him high.
Rastafari, I.
And once you're wicked vices, yeah. While the enemies sit and they watch and they call, the blessing multiply, yeah. Some of my son got mad, stop me, I'm the meat, I should go back to tap each other. When them look at me, shut a dozen button, when they have a oof, a picture. I can't see us.
Never before has the world seen a king like him.
It's empty.
Is what's in your hand, stay tuned. This one is healing. Yes, all right, yes, all right. That was healing. Let's see him. Yes, all right. And coming up is what's in your hand. Okay, so stay tuned and don't you move. Yes, indeed. What's in your hand?
My natural peace.
By the way, yes, so just stay tuned. And thanks for all the people that are calling and listening to the Reggae Vibrations on WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
My natural peace.
Yes, those trusting in the Lord is like a Mount Zion, which cannot be removed, but abided by forever. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide in the shadows of the Almighty I. Jah God and I going out and I coming in from this time forth and forevermore. All praise unto Jah. Rastafari. Thanks for all the people that call in and listen to the Reggae Vibration. Yes. Jah God and protect each and every one. Rastafari.
Until the philosophy which old one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned. Everywhere is war. It's a war that until there are no longer first class and second class citizens of any nation, until the color of a man's skin is of no more significance than the color of his eyes. Miss a war that until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all without regard to race. It is a war that until that day the dream of lasting peace, world citizenship, rule of international morality will remain but a fleeting illusion to be pursued but never attained. Now everywhere is war. And until the ignoble and unhappy regime that hold our brothers in Angola, in Mozambique, South Africa, subhuman bondage, have been toppled, totally destroyed. Well, everywhere is war. A war, war in the east, war in the west, war up north, war down south, war, war, rumors of a war, and until that day, the African continent will not know peace. We Africans will fight. We find it necessary, and we know we shall win.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
The victory of good over evil. Good over evil.
and don't cry. Your folks might understand you by and by. Just move on up toward your destination. Though you may find from time to time complications.
Says about 30% are unemployed. That's why I'm working hard to get this surplus food here. Some of you say to me, well, I'm not like you. I'm not a congressman. I haven't got education. I haven't got work. But you're a human being. And you know what you've got? You've got in your hand the power to use your vote and to use even those few cents you get from welfare to spend them only where you want to spend them. Remember that. A young slave boy stood one day before the greatest ruler of his day. And God said to Moses, what's in your hand? And Moses said, Lord, only I've got a stick, that's all. He said, well, let me use what's in your hand. And God used that slave boy with a stick in his hand to divide the Red Seas, march through a wilderness, bring water out of rocks, manna from heaven, and bring his people to freedom land. What's in your hand? What's in your hand? George Washington Carver, who was so frail that he was traded for a broken-down horse as a slave boy. And George Washington Carver, sitting in the science laboratory at Tuskegee, told me, he said, Dr. Powell, he said, I just go out on the fields each morning at 5 o'clock, and I let God guide me. And I bring back these little things and work them over my laboratory, and that man did more to revolutionize the agricultural science of peanuts and of cotton and sweet potato than any other human being in the field of agricultural science. What's in your hand? Just let God use you, that's all. What's in your hand? I've got a string in my hand, that's all, and I'm flying a kite. And way up in the heavens, lightning strikes it, and I, Benjamin Franklin, discover for the first time the possibilities of electricity with a string in my hand. What's in your hand? Little hunchback sitting in a Roman jail. I haven't got anything in my hand but an old quill pen, but God says, write what I tell you to write. And Paul wrote, I have run my race with patience. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. Henceforth, there's laid up to me a account of it. What's in your hand, little boy? All I've got is a slingshot. and the enemies of my people are great and big and more numerous than we are. Well, little David, go down to the brook and pick out a few stones and come on back and close your eyes if you want to and pull back that slingshot and let him go. And David killed the biggest enemy, the leader of the giants, against his people, and his people became free, just letting God guide a stone in his hand. And a few years passed, and David is a king. And God says, what's in your hand? He said, I've got a harp in my hand. He said, well, David, play on your harp. And he played, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Maketh me to lie down in green pastures. Leadeth me beside still waters. Yea, though I walk through the valley in the shadow of death, I fear no evil. What's in your hand? What's in your hand? Man hanging on a cross. I've got two nails in my hand. Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdrawest thyself from me, whither shall I go? And that man with two nails in his hand split history in half, B.C. and A.D. And what's in your hand tonight, people of Cambridge? You've got God in your hand, and he'll let you win because he's on your side and one with God, always in the majority. So walk with him and talk with him and work with him and stick together and fight together. And with God's hand in your hand, the victory will be accomplished here sooner than you dreamed, sooner than you hoped, sooner than you prayed for, sooner than you imagined. Good night and God bless you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Rick Young. Another segment of What's in Your Hand Radio at WATR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem. And getting ready for another great program, another great show. And we're going to be talking about your favorite subject. Your favorite subject, I guess. Can you guess what that is? One of your favorite subjects. One of your favorite subjects. Take a guess. Take a guess. Here we go.
Big WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Money, 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 ladies and gentlemen, all about that money, that mean, mean green. Money will drive some people out their mind. And some people will use money for good. That's what I like. I like that people use money for good. I heard a gentleman say yesterday, he says, a brick? He says, a brick, it's not good or bad. You can take a brick and break through a window. You could take a brick and build a school, a church, a hospital. So it's not what it is, it's how you use it. Money, and so money is the same way. Money is amoral. And I have a guest in the studio that's going to be sharing some money, money, money principles. His name is Philip Soyvan. Philip Soyvan. Good morning, Philip. How are you doing this morning?
Doing great, Nick. Thank you.
We pronounce it Philip. You pronounce it.
No, Philip.
Philip, okay. Right.
Yes.
I thought it was Felipe.
Right. Well, they tend to call me Felipe because Philip is not a common way of pronouncing it.
Right.
So that's, I always have to rectify them a little bit.
Right, and you are from?
I'm from France.
France, yes. Right.
I've been here for about 20 years now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this song, talking about money. So many people have not really, they playing the game, but they don't know the rules of the game. They have not been successful at the money game. Why are so many people failing at the money game?
Well, I will say this to you, Rick. It's because we mentioned many times about the money game, so you imply that there are rules. And it's a game, so you don't play football on a baseball court. You have to know how money works in your life. And unfortunately, it's not really taught in school simply because it tend to be a family matter that the school doesn't want to be involved in. And around the dinner table, parents are not necessarily the best role model of how money is supposed to be saved, and therefore we don't really teach the children the proper way. And, you know, it goes on by generation to generation to the point where we're still dealing with having not enough or not being able to achieve the things we want to do because we don't have any plan. And I would say you this. There are three fundamental root cause of all financial problem. One is there is no plan. Do you realize that we buy toilet paper and tissue, about $120 worth of that on a yearly basis, and we don't take a piece of paper and write out a plan of how we're going to be wealthy? And that's across the board. Everybody, I would say 95% of the population doesn't have even a written plan every year when they start a new year. That's one cause. The second cause is there's no accountability whatsoever. I mean, you can say to yourself, I'm going to be rich looking at the mirror, but that's you in the mirror. There's nobody else around you. When you become accountable to somebody, then you have to work. You have to go to work. And the last one, I would say, a very important one, is that, and I'm sorry about to say that, but bank institution and insurance companies, institution, you know, in terms of finances, they do not profit from you getting out of debt. So why would they teach you how to be out of debt and becoming financially stable or even independent? So those are the problems.
Well, I must say that you have three children.
Yes, I do.
And you have taught them very well. How old are your children?
One is finishing school in Ramapo in accounting. Another one is studying in Colombia getting his degree in psychology. And the other one is working with me because when he finished his graduate course in Rutgers in New Jersey, he had two choices. He could go to Asia and teach English and making some money there. Or he looked at the kind of money I was making, helping people to get out of debt and becoming financially independent and making the kind of money. He said, I want to go with you and work with you, Dad. I say, yes, you can work with me, but you're going to start from scratch. So here's the thing. People need to understand that for every reward, there's a process to go through, and it's not that you can go halfway and succeed. And we have few of those in this world where, you know, we call them the silver spoon babies or whatever we call them. But learning how to be successful in life starts from understanding what are the rules and getting from A to Z and understanding all the aspect of how to become financially successful so that eventually you want to share that with other people. And that has been my quest. I understood 15, 16 years ago, actually, that I needed to have an edge in terms of what need to be understood about how myself can I handle money. And I started to learn and study. And even today, people say to me, where should I invest my money? Instead, you should be asking me what kind of book I read. So it's all about education, really.
Financial education.
Yes.
That is very much lacking in this country, financial education.
Right, because we have a tendency to want things immediately, and we expect result to come right away, but we're not willing to go through the process of learning and then internalizing and then taking the step, you know, taking actions. That's the pitfall that we have in terms of wanting to have things, you know, immediately.
So you ran into a program by Dave Ramsey.
Right. It was a program that our church was wanted to offer to our congregation, and since they knew that I was in that field, they asked me if I wanted to teach it. So I was looking at the program and looked at all the DVDs, probably two or three times each of them, and I said, this is great stuff. Because whoever is offering this program is not licensed in any field of finance. Therefore, he has no interest whatsoever in teaching what he is teaching, but really is teaching out of his own heart and his own desire to share what kind of experience he had in his life and how he can help other people to be successful without the intention to sell them any kind of services or products. So I thought that was the best type of program that I have come across that I could also share with other people, knowing the kind of experience that I have myself and the kind of intention that I have in educating other people to understand more about those rules that money has.
You just said something very valuable. You said you watched the DVDs two or three times. Some people might not get through them one time.
Again,
they listen to a little bit of it and they put it down. Or they might listen all the way through and then that's it. They do nothing. But you listen to it two or three times. Go ahead.
The reason I did this is because there are three words in our vocabulary, English word, which is, they are very dangerous word, is to say, I know that, or I already know that. And that's the problem.
Because the
moment you say that, your mind shut down.
Yeah.
And you pretend that you know everything, and soon after that, you know everything about nothing and nothing about everything, and you think you know everything.
Smoking is no good for you. I know that.
Yeah, I know that.
But I'm smoking.
That's right. Same principle, it applies.
So this program that Dave Ramsey started is called Financial Peace University.
Right. It's a Dave Ramsey program.
And I want to know how you came up with that name, Financial Peace University.
Again, he's trying to put together two words that don't seem to go together, you know, like airline services. Have you ever got any kind of good service with an airline? No. Financial Peace seems to be two separate entities, and the program is wanting to bring those two things together, which means it has a lot to do with basics, essential, and fundamentals of how money work, but it also has to do with using your imagination to go further in terms of creating wealth in your life. So, you know, Hosea 4:6 says, my children are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. But Albert Einstein also said that imagination is more powerful than knowledge. So what I like about this program, it brings those two things together. That's why it's very important to do this program in groups, because in groups, you have people who have, let's say, one idea. But when you come into a group, now you have multiple ideas that you can share with each other. And then you can start, again, taking the steps to go a little bit further into your financial life that's going to better your life. But you can't do it alone. I don't think you can do it alone. You have to be with other people.
Mm-hmm. This is a 9-week course.
Well, originally it has 13 weeks, and we have to understand that 13 weeks is longer. 9 weeks, of course, you're gonna have to shrink a little about certain topics, but at the same time, whatever topic it's covered, it's more a matter of accountability among the people who are attending the class program, and really share their ideas, and as well as some successful. Aspect of other people who have succeeded in doing other things in that particular field that we can share to other people as well, because it's really to some extent a program of show and tell, but at the same time it's learning from other people who might be a little bit more advanced than others, and it's really putting them into the same wagon and going in the same direction. So of course, he offers this program online, but it's not the same. You know, it's you watching the video alone and hoping that you're going to make the change. I've not seen too much success in that area doing it this way.
But have you seen success in people coming to the groups and coming in, interacting with other individuals?
Absolutely. I've been doing it for 2 years. And the main point, again, I will stress this more than anything else, is accountability. Mm. So when people come to the class program alone, I stress the importance of bringing a partner. It doesn't cost more. It's just that it's two instead of one. It's really the Noah's Ark principle. You know, they all came in pair. They all came at different time. I mean, the cheetah came with the same time with the turtle. it's not a matter of you being able to do it on your own. It's a matter of being accountable to someone. And I know there are some people out there who think that they can do it alone, but I'd like to have some feedback from him, from them. But I don't really hear too much about people doing it and being successful alone. If you are successful alone, that means you're naked. It's always somebody who did something for you, at least did your clothes so that you can get keep warm during winter. Somebody has done something for you. So people who say to me, "I'm a self-made man," I look at them and I say, "I feel sorry for you." Okay, because there's no such a thing as being a self-made man. Otherwise, you'd be living in an island somewhere.
Right.
Right?
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand Radio at WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem. And in the studio, I have Philip Soevan. Soevan.
That's the easiest way to pronounce it. To tell you the truth, if I was in France, I would be called Soevan.
Wow. Wow. Well, you know, when you talk about having an accountability partner, one of the things that's very, very personal with people is their money. They don't like discuss their money issues because it's a very private and sacred thing. They don't talk about money. It's private and sacred. What do you say to that?
I would say it has two components in this. If you are single and you're dealing with money, then you shouldn't really have any budgeting problem because you're single. But at the same time, if you have a friend that you really trust and you're able to talk about your money problem, then go ahead and do it. Because it's very similar to go to a doctor and you'd say to the doctor, "Doctor, it hurts right here," and the doctor asks you to lift up your shirt and say, "Oh no, I don't want to be naked in front of you," then the doctor can't really prescribe anything, right? Because he needs to know what's your situation. So you have to find somebody you can trust. If you are married, then it's really a matter of understanding each other's priorities. There's always somebody who is very much focused on making sure that the payments, the bills are paid, and the other one who wants to go to the mall and buy anything. So the question is, you have to find a middle point where you can actually make whatever budget you are on to make it work. So it's very, very important that the minds meet together and understand that everybody has different needs. I understand that. But as a couple or as a family, you need to come together and understand how to make it work. So we come back to the same thing, which is understanding how money works in your life, and take the steps so that you don't have a fight every time at the end of the month.
Now this course is done at the Learning Center, which is on 4 West 43rd Street.
Correct.
So you had the first class yesterday, April 6th. So it started already, so can someone come?
I would say they can, but if you come in the middle, then you only get really an approximation of what needs to be done, and it's really a matter of, it's a process. You don't run a 40-yard distance, starting at 200. The same time is I don't want to stop people from coming in. There's no fee except for you to have your workbook. You can come without a workbook, but after a while, I'm gonna be in front of your face and say, "Why you don't have your workbook?" Again, it's accountability. All right. So everybody's welcome, but come with a workbook. You can get your workbook on the Dave Ramsey website, which is the name DaveRamsey.com, and get your workbook.
Right. Now, one of the things that I heard you say is that this program is a no-excuse program. What do you mean by that?
No-excuse program. What I mean by that is simply that I hear a lot about people say, "I want to be financially independent, but all kind of excuse. I don't have the time to come to the class. I don't have the time to learn. I don't have the time to study the material. No excuse. So as I mentioned yesterday in the class, I say I have a little plaque in front of, right in front of me actually, above my computer that says, excuse are tools of incompetence. Those who are using them seldom build anything. So you have a choice. You can make excuse or you can make money, but you can't make both. Right.
Okay. So very interesting program. So it's called Financial Peace University. And how did you find out? So they brung it to your church or your church?
So after looking at all the videos, I said, okay, how do we go by doing it? And they were not really sure. So I took on myself the responsibility to bringing up into our own program. We have a website where we actually advertise the different community events. And slowly but surely, a few people came, and it started to grow, in such a way. The also the fact that Dave Ramsey provide the logistics through their own website, and 43rd Street, the 4 West 43rd Street, being located in a very central area of Manhattan, make it very easy for people to actually have access to our location. And they just have to plug and look into the Dave Ramsey website where is the closest location for them to attend the program, because this is actually in many different other areas of Manhattan. Many churches offer that program as well. The reason being behind is I believe that many churches have a tithing problem.
Have what?
Tithing.
Tithing, tithing.
Giving the tenth of your income?
Yes.
Right. And we tend to think that it's a faith problem. I believe it's a money management problem. And it's easy for a pastor, a minister, and possibly a priest to offer this program to its own congregation so that people can have a better idea of where the money is so that they can easily tithe. So there have been results shown through this program that has improved the tithing level of churches once we offer that program. And that's because when you are in charge and control of your own money, you are more able to pay yourself first, because that's one of the first principle in if you want to be successful is to pay yourself first. What does it mean? It means that, okay, you have to take care of your expenses and your bills, I understand that. But paying yourself first is more important than anything else. And paying yourself first means also including God in that process. Because giving 10% of your income, what you're saying is, everything I have, everything I live for, my eyes, my hands, the way I breathe, it's given to me from God. So my income is because of God. Without it, I wouldn't be able to earn an income. So the 10% is a reminder of my debt to God. And if you don't do that, then God is allowed to take anything else. If you don't get if you don't give your 10%, he will take your 90%. You know, David, in the Bible, God gave him Israel. But what did he do? He took Bathsheba, the wife of one of his lieutenant in the army. What did God do? He took back Israel. So be careful what you're doing in terms of keeping away from giving to God, because you won't be able to go forward into living a life of abundance. That's the problem. It's a spiritual thing.
Wow. Okay. All right. Give you 10%. Now, what if you're not involved in any church or any religious institution?
10% is not necessarily always about money. It's also about time. Okay? 10% is not just a dollar amount. It's also about how you serve and live for the sake of other people as well. So you have to figure out what it is that you can do for other people so that you can not only better their life, but by doing so, you will better yours. So every day you should be waking up and say, where am I going to be next in the next 2 or 3 hours, or I'm gonna meet the right people at the right time for the betterment of all. So those are things that you want to think about in terms of living your life, because money only comes to people who are very active for helping other people. They are happy. Money comes only to happy people. It tends to go away from people who always complain.
Now, one of the things that I've heard Dave talk about is money and behavior, the behavior of money.
Not the behavior of money. It's you in relationship to money, which means your program is called What's in Your Hand.
Right.
So what happened is most people, what they have in their hand, that's all they got. And they don't want to let it go because that's all they got. And because their hand is clenched, that's all they're going to have. You have to open your hand. And of course, some of it will go, but some of it will be able to come in. So it's really, when you talk about behavior, it's about how do you look at the money you have? Do you keep it for yourself because you don't have enough? Or you share it with other people who don't have enough? It's really a matter of how you think about it.
Most people are living paycheck to paycheck. How do they get out of that? How do they get away from that paycheck to paycheck living?
Okay, we live in a monetary system. I won't deny it. Paycheck to paycheck. At the same time, are you using money as the way to comfort yourself and then always running out of it all the time? Because if you make $10 and you spend $9 of it, I would consider this to be a certain degree of happiness. But if you make $10 and you spend $11, then you are putting yourself in a state of misery. And with misery comes complaint. And with misery comes complaint and justification of why you are where you are. And that's why we have more people who complain than more people happy.
Well, now you're going into what they call credit. And a lot of people have problems with credit. They don't really understand the credit part of the money game.
Right.
And they get in trouble with credit. You give them a piece of plastic, that's it.
Yes.
They go bananas. They go bonkers.
I think we've become accustomed to borrow other people's money and turn it into our own to the point where we don't realize it's not our money anyway. So if you have to borrow money, do it, but get out of it as fast as you can. And don't linger on it. Don't think it's a way of life. That's the only problem that we have here in terms of using credit cards and all this. As soon as you get a credit card, you think you are you use your credit line limit, which is probably somewhere around 5,000, 10,000, 20,000, and we think it's our money. It's not your money. Does not the Bible say, you know, the slave is the borrower is a slave to the lender? You want to get out of it as fast as you can. Because living in a state of quote-unquote slavery is not talking about the same kind of slavery we talked in the past, but it's the same saying that I'm not in control and I accept it. And then we live in that state of denial to the point where it has become a way of life, and therefore we think it's the way to go. Credit is a good thing to a certain extent to build credibility, but at the same time, I agree with Dave Ramsey saying that maybe one of your goals in life is to have no FICO score, which is your level of credibility in terms of the way you can borrow. What if you don't have to borrow anymore except for the biggest purchase in your life, which is probably buying a house? Other than this, you should be prepared to save money enough to buy things more on the cash side of your life. Because I remember someone a long time ago told me that cash is king. I didn't really understand what it meant because we have all those debit cards, credit cards, plastic cards. And in what way cash is king? Cash is king in the sense that it has a higher power of negotiation when you go and buy a high-end item, like a piece of furniture. It's much easier for you to negotiate with Benjamin in your hand, Benjamin Franklin, $100 bill in your hand, than to have a credit card. Because credit cards cost money for the furniture store. And the cash is your power to negotiate for a lower price. I've done it many times. It works all the time. And if it doesn't work, guess what? You can leave and go somewhere else where you can get a better deal. But you can do this with a credit card.
So the borrower, I'm going to repeat that again because that needs to be repeated. The borrower is a slave to the lender.
That's correct.
Wow. That's pretty powerful. That's pretty powerful. That's a powerful, powerful statement.
Yeah. And you know what? When you borrow some money, maybe not at the bank, but even you might have borrowed money from a friend, right? And guess what? You have altered the relationship just because of that. Because if you think, oh, no, it doesn't happen with my friend, you're still the slave and he's still the lender. And you're still the borrower, I mean. But you're a slave too. Because now every time you see him, you remember that you owe him money. The relationship has been slightly altered. And if you are in a situation where you can lend money to a friend, don't lend it. Or your family, I would say more to your family, don't lend it, just give it to him. And then and forget about it. You might not be in that situation to do that. But understand, it's very important that whenever you borrow money, the relationship between the two parties has been altered. Bank, it's a matter of a business, but among other people, among people of in a friendly or familial relationship, as a result is altered.
Okay, so you could be going along, doing everything right, paying your bills on time,
right,
doing everything right, working, taking care of everything, and then all of a sudden, bam. An emergency happens, something, the car breaks down or something in the house needs to be fixed, the washing machine breaks down an emergency happens and you're not prepared for that emergency. Dave has, in the program, he has an emergency fund and he calls it the GOK fund.
GOK fund.
God only knows.
That's right. Yes, God only knows. But at the same time, you know it too. Is it possible that in the next 2 or 3 years, your car may have, let's say, an alternator issue or may have a leak? Is it possible? Is it possible that one of your kitchenware devices may break down, like the refrigerator? And is it possible that maybe one of your kids hurt himself or herself and you may have to pay some deductible off of your HMO plan or whatever plan you have, or if you don't have a plan? So you know things will happen. The only people that have nothing happening for them are those who are actually buried 3 feet under the ground. If you are a living being, you will have situation that requires for you to pay something that we're not supposed to be, but you were not supposed to pay. The thing is, that's what it's called emergency. So have some money set aside. Wherever you are in your life, the worst case, you can save $20, $30, $40 a month, and you put it in a jar somewhere. I don't know. You put it under the mattress. That's an emergency. That's something you're going to need, not for the ordering a pizza. Pizza man comes at the door and the bell rings, say, oh, this is an emergency. And then you go under your mattress, you take the money, and you pay the pizza. That's not an emergency. If you don't have an emergency money, everything that will happen in your life will be an emergency. You don't want to be living on your tiptoes all the time. You want to be in a situation where you know you have a backup, God forbid something happened to you. That's the first level of emergency kind of money that you should have.
So basically, when you have your money situation in order and you're not stressed out about money, everything is taken care of, that's where the peace comes in. You have a peace of mind.
A certain relative peace, yes, but you need to go on to other steps. Having an emergency account is one thing. Now, what if your main breadwinner passes away? Do you think the company where he works or she works will still continue to pay your income? I don't think so. So you need to also be prepared for that as well. And the sooner you do it, the better you'll be in a position of paying it, because it's all about being younger and in healthy, and that's when we don't really think about it. The only problem is when it happens, then it's too late, because you have not prepared yourself enough. I'm talking about what it used to be called death insurance, and nobody wanted to buy death insurance, so the insurance company started to think maybe we should call it life insurance. And really what it is, really what it is income protection, you know, for the people that depends on the money you make.
Wow. Well, you know what? I think this song here.
Cash, cold, that's what I need. My phone, they're bothering
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Once again, back is the incredible
WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem.
Mic check.
Keep it locked on WHCR 90.3 FM.
Okay.
New York.
Help in the fight against violence at the third annual New York City Rising Stars Take Charge Basketball Over Violence, held on Saturday, April 6, 2013. The first game begins at 2 p.m. with New York City coaches versus the NYPD All-Stars. The second game will begin at 4 p.m. with New York City's top varsity boys versus celebrities. Basketball Against Violence is a free event and will take place at the City College of New York, located at 160 Convent Avenue in Harlem. For more information, call School Safety Agent Blackwell or Agent Carter at 718-730-8550. That's 718-730-8550.
The City College of New York Educational Theater Program presents Family Arts Day, Saturday, April the 27th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Family Arts Day is filled with fun for the whole family. There will be face painting, mask making, clowns, sing-alongs, puppets, live performances, raffle prizes, and more. That's Family Arts Day, Saturday, April the 27th from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. This free event will be held at the Aaron Davis Hall, located at 150 Convent Avenue at 135th Street.
On Saturday, April 6th and Wednesday, April 10th, Councilman Robert Jackson and the American Italian Cancer Foundation will bring free mammography screenings to the residents of West Harlem and Washington Heights. The service is limited to women 40 years and older who are residents of New York City and have not had a mammography in the last 12 months. Mobile care clinics will be stationed in front of the George Bruce Library at 125th Street and Amsterdam Avenue and New York & Company at 181st and Broadway. If you're eligible for this service, please call 877-628-9090 to schedule an appointment.
You can be a healthcare professional. It's never too early to think about becoming a doctor, nurse, dentist, or pharmacist. At Mentoring in Medicine's conference, you can meet various experts who will tell you how you can become a healthcare professional and what they do. Mentoring in Medicine's 7th annual Yes, I Can Be a Healthcare Professional conference will be held on Saturday, April the 27th from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. The conference will be held at Frederick Douglass Academy, located at 2581 Adam Clayton Powell Jr. Boulevard in Harlem. This event is free and for young people ages 8 to 28. For more information, call 718-920-6626. That's 718-920-6626, or visit the website www.medicalmentor.org.
By the time of his death, Martin Luther King had undergone, quote, a radical revolution of values. Who is the radical MLK? Join us at the Riverside Church to find out on April 4th, 2013 at 7 p.m.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Speakers include Ben Cheney, Ramsey Clark, Immortal Technique, Cynthia McKinney, Jamal Joseph, and Dan Wright. That's April 4th, Riverside Church, 7 p.m.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Harlem's got its own radio station.
Once again, back is the incredible
WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem.
Mic check.
Keep it locked on WHCR 90.3 FM.
Okay.
New York.
Greetings. This is Honey from Harlem 411. Tune in to Harlem 411, Friday nights at 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. for information on health, education, housing, community events, and more. Harlem 411 serves information to you with the opportunity to call in with your questions. Harlem 411 produced to serve the community's needs. Let us serve you with information Friday night, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Harlem 411.
Let's go to church. Let's go to church.
It's morning praise with Dalton Anderson. Sunday mornings, 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Listen and enjoy the best in contemporary, traditional, quartet, gospel comedy, holy hip-hop, and gospel house music. With the man who knows how to wake and bake and shake you right out your gospel beds. It's Morning Praise with Dalton Anderson. Sunday mornings, 8 a.m. on WHCR 90.3 FM. Let's go to church.
Tune in to What's Going On Sundays, 3 p.m. to 4:30 with your girl Steph. I love sports. I like to talk about everything, knockouts, big shots, game seven, and game-changing plays. You need heart to win. Yes, heart. You'll think twice about everything you hear or see after my take. Why? Because I'm changing the game. What's going on? I'll tell you. Sundays, 3 p.m. to 4:30 on WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Did you ever think that you would sell out tours? Have a show with 50 million views?
Did you ever think that you would be this rich? Did you ever think that you would have these hits? Did you ever think that you would be the dime? Have a crib with a 50-acre lot? Did you ever think that you would be this paid? There were times when your ass was real free. Did you ever think that you would sell out tours? Have a show with 50 million views?
I used to play the game at night, the same old same, dreaming about city lights. It was my only life, and now it's worldwide shows. As if I hit light on, now I can't go nowhere without people wanting to know.
Did you ever think that you would be this rich? Did you ever think that you would have these hits?
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand Radio at WHCR 90.3 FM, the voice of Harlem. People are, we are located on the campus of City College, and people are getting bachelor's degrees, master's degrees, and PhDs right here in these hallways. But we also need a money degree. I heard Stephanie doing a promo for her show. She said, I'm changing the game. Well, we need to change the money game. And during the break, Philip and I, my guest, Philip, Soe Yvonne, were talking about this. I see a lot of people walking around doing scratch-offs. And Philip said, and you said what, Philip?
What did I say? Oh yeah, I was asking Rick, where are all those shops where you actually buy those tickets? And usually those shops are located in areas that the average income is pretty low. But when you go to expensive neighborhood, you don't find those shops. So I wonder why.
Yeah. You don't see those scratch-off games.
Yeah, so rich people don't play lottery, I guess. Only people who need money play lottery. Again, they are hoping on the odds of one to, I don't know how many million, that they're going to become millionaire. Yet they're spending $20 a week. If you save $20 a week, which is about $80 a month, at an average rate of, let's say, 8-9%, I don't have a calculator, but I'm sure you'll be better off than scratching a $20 ticket every week and never winning.
Well, they win sometimes. They win. And you know what they do when they win? They go right back and play again.
Again, we're not talking about massive people understanding the money game. No. We're talking about exclusions.
When they win $100, $200, $50 or whatever. I don't know what they win, but they win enough just to keep you coming
back. Right, the satisfaction winning. But then once you win, you just won, and then you're looking for another way to win again. I'm talking about a lifetime of winning that you don't have to worry about buying a lot of tickets.
A lifetime of winning. Wow, that's powerful. A lifetime of winning. And also during the break, you talked about this website called 3jars.com. Can you talk about that?
Yes, we're talking about generations and generations of people who have not learned how to get ahead financially. And it starts with, again, the educational process. If you are a parent and you are well advanced in your life, then whatever you can learn about the money game and the rule of money, then apply it. But by God, you have children that you can teach the right way. And we were talking with Rick on the way here to the studio that it's not easy for parents to teach children how to manage money because, let's face it, parents are not necessarily a great role model about being financially secure or even financially independent. But they have a lifetime of experience. And I came across that website, the 3Jars program, which basically means teaching your children the value of money. How many times have you gone to church every Sunday and you gave to your kids a dollar from your pocket, from the last receipt of your the pizza you bought yesterday? You had a dollar left in your pocket, and you gave it to your child and say, "Give it at the plate when it comes around." The child was only your carrier. He had no idea about what that money is for. So the 3Jar is all about understanding the meaning of saving, the meaning of giving, and the meaning of spending. How do they get money in that jar? It's simply by helping around the house. So go to that website, learn a little bit about it, and I will tell you for sure the children will understand what it means to have money in their pocket and how to earn it.
You know, this is for children, but I think a lot of adults can benefit from this from themselves. You know, instead of saying, "Oh, this is for a child," I think some adults could benefit from this.
Yeah, well, it's based on chore in the house, so the things you want to do, of course, you want to adapt it to your own style and your own age. But basically, it's all about helping children to understand the value of money, which means, guess what? It might change your family tree, and this time it might fork.
Yeah, it says 3jars.com, save, spend, and share. And basically it says where kids learn to earn and use money responsibly.
Right. I was in my early explanation about going to church and giving money to your child, is it's much better for him to have a jar where he has to give some of the money that he earned, because he will realize the importance of helping others. And as he grows, it will really build up on his character.
Right. Let's see. Let's take a look at this. Let's see what we could come up here with.
Well, there's a video that actually gives you some explanation.
Yeah. Huh?
There's a video that explains how to use the 3Jars.
Yeah.
So it shows someone doing some chore in the backyard.
Yeah.
Those are kids. And once they finish to collect all the dead leaves, the parents give him, let's say, a dollar. So you may want to give a dollar for each of those jars. One that will go in saving, one will go in sharing, one will go into spending. And the spending part of it is they may want to buy something that they want. You provide the need. So that's another aspect also, defining what is a want and what is a need. So if they want to buy, let's say, an iPhone, you're not going to buy them for them. They'll have to work for it.
And does this encourage entrepreneurship as well?
I believe it is. it's really building up a certain character and an attitude about you and money as you grow up. And the giving part is by far the most important one, because if you just give a dollar or whatever amount you give for a tithing, so that your child during the Sunday school gave it to the church, he was just the borrower of your own money. He has no idea what that money was for. He just gave it away.
Right. So that's good. I sent threejars.com. THREE Jars, JARS.com.
Right. I'm not a sponsor of that website. You don't have to subscribe to it. Just look at the principle and apply them into your own household. Basically, just buy three jars and then put those three words on the jar. And at the end of the week, gather as a family and look at what kind of chore they did during the week around the house, and give them appropriately a certain amount of money that will go in those three jars.
Now, a lot of people spend money on emotion. It's a very emotional thing with money. You know, people, just like eating is emotional. Money spending, some people just, I feel terrible, I feel bad, I want to go shopping. Talk about money and emotion.
Again, it comes back to having a partner in your life and being able to share some of the challenges you have in life. Because you will always find a way to satisfy yourself by getting something that you couldn't get elsewhere. And that's how you go on a shopping spree. So if you have a friend that is close to you and you make a pact that whenever you are down or whenever you have a situation you want to share with that friend, then that would help. But make sure that it's not your shopping buddy, because otherwise you'd be ending up spending even more. Make sure that you have somebody who can tell you right in your face what you need to hear, that doesn't care whether or not the relationship is going to be altered because he's your friend or she's your friend. You need to have somebody to be with when it comes to situation like that.
Well, speaking of relationships, there are many divorces and breakups because of money.
Right.
Can you talk about that?
It's not anymore until death do us apart, right? It's probably until debt. Debt do us support. Yes, it's true that the majority of the divorces are caused by money and lack thereof of the money, and it comes down to having a plan. You don't get into a relationship early in time and say, "Honey, this is my plan. In the next 5 years, we're gonna be broke. Our house will be on short sales, and we may have to file for bankruptcy. Please marry me." It doesn't work like this. You may want to ask yourself, when was the last time you had a conversation with your spouse, kneecap to kneecap, about where you stand financially, and instead of fighting, put it on paper and figure out what needs to be done. Again, it's a partnership program. It's not somebody who does it individually and the other one doesn't care about it. And actually, it's one of the topic which is a very, very, very popular topic in the Dave Ramsey program, talking about different mindset between husband and wife and how we can come together and make it happen.
Right. And also, building wealth is not a sprint, it's a marathon. Can you speak about that?
Well, there's again two different ways to make money. You build a foundation upon which you will become financially wealthy, or you can rob a bank. Usually, it doesn't end up well. The thing is, it's a marathon. What it means by that is, again, I was mentioning the Noah's Ark principle. Everybody came on board, whether it was the fastest animal, the cheetah, or the slowest animal, the turtle. It's a matter of putting step one after the other and understanding that there are steps in order to come to a point where you feel financially secure. One of the steps that Dave Ramsey program emphasizes is right away save for an emergency account. Once you've been able to do that, you feel that you can do even more. And it's really a matter of being encouraged to do that by letting other people know that you have already succeeded in doing this, and then let other people know that it's possible so that you can inspire others. And by inspiring others, you actually fuel yourself with energy to do even more. So in regard to that, yes, it's not a sprint, it's a marathon. You have to go, you don't become rich overnight. If you do, it's probably not the right way. Because I've seen people, and give you an example of day traders, right? Are you familiar with day traders? People who do investment online on a daily basis, looking at their screen. I don't remember the statistic per se, but 2 years ago, 4 million trade, only 7% of people made money, and we're talking about a lot of people doing investment online on a daily basis. So always looking for a way to make a quick money. It doesn't work.
Right. Now, you have an article here in the magazine here, and the article, title of the article is called Uncommon Sense. Tell me about this interview that you did in this magazine.
It was about a year ago. The magazine is called UC. It's a church magazine worldwide, and they were interested about
pretty well put together.
It's pretty nicely made.
Right.
And they were interested about my view on finance because one of the things that a church in general is stressing is about the spirit and not too much about the money. So I had take that position about understanding that also money is a spiritual thing, in a sense that you have to understand what type of person you are. In the Bible, it says, "As a man thinketh, so is he." And even General Ford said, "If you think you can do it, you can. If you think you can't, you're right." So it's really a matter of changing your thinking, and as you change your thinking. Because finally, you know, when you look at it, your mindset is a very powerful thing. The mind, one of the primary functions of the mind is really to keep you alive. So any change in your life that you try to do, the mind will try to go against it because it wants to keep you where you are. It doesn't want any change. So you have to keep repeating yourself that you are better than what you think you are. And that's why one of the great inspirational speakers that I've known was Brian Tracy. He's still alive, Brian Tracy, who says, you have to keep saying to yourself, I love myself, I love myself. And it may sounds to be self-centered, but it's all about self-respect, because once you have self-respect, gradually money comes to you as a result of the way you feel. So they wanted me to address a little bit of that issue, not being simply on the money side per se, but understanding that it's an important part of life that we cannot just avoid and live in a state of denial because we are totally and exclusively focused on the spiritual growth of our own being.
Now, you've helped people with money before. What is the worst situation, money situation you've seen that's like it was really bad?
Oh my God! There are different cases. I mean, different people, different stories, different situation. But yes, there were situation where I won't mention name, of course. But 2 years ago, I came across a lady who was a nurse, and she had about $130,000 of life insurance, but she was making like $60,000 a year. So husband is a truck driver, traveling all the time. She had a Down syndrome child and a daughter, a very bright daughter, probably Ivy League material. And when I sat down with her and her husband, she said, well, I have insurance, I'm a nurse, I know about my own health, so don't worry about it, that's all we need. And 6 months later, she had medical checkup, and she never woke up. So her husband only got $132,000 with a child who has a Down syndrome. So question is, $132,000, how long do you think it's going to last? that was a very difficult situation for me to resolve, because at that point she didn't really implement the plan that I was offering her to implement.
Wow. With that said, I'm going to play another song that you recommended. Let's see if we can get this song going.
Magazine, smiling next to all the queen. Oh, every time I close my eyes, I see my name in shiny lights. Yeah, a different city every night. Oh, I swear the world better prepare for when I'm a billionaire.
Yeah, I would have a show like Oprah. I would be the host of Everyday Christmas. Give Travi a wish list. I'd probably pull a Angelina and Brad Pitt and adopt a bunch of babies that ain't never had shit. Give away a few Mercedes like, here, lady, have this. And last but not least, grant somebody their last wish. It's been a couple months that I've been single, so you can call me Travi Claus, minus the ho-ho. Get it? I'd probably visit with Katrina hit. And damn sure do a lot more than FEMA did. Yeah, can't forget about me, stupid. Everywhere I go, I'ma have my own theme music.
Oh, every time I close my eyes,
what you see, bro?
I see my name in shiny lights.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, yeah. What else? A different city every night. Oh,
yeah.
I swear, the world better prepare
for
when I'm a billionaire.
Basketball with the president, dunking on his delegates. Then I compliment him on his political etiquette. Toss a couple million in the air just for the heck of it. But keep the 520 tins and bins completely separate. Yeah, I'd be in a whole new tax bracket. We in recession, but let me take a crack at it. I'd probably take whatever's left and just split it up, so everybody that I love can have a couple bucks. And not a single tummy around me would know what hungry was, eating good, sleeping soundly. I know we all have a similar dream. Go in your pocket, pull out your wallet, put it in the air and sing.
I wanna be a billionaire so fucking bad.
So bad.
Buy all of the things I never had.
Buy everything.
I wanna be on the cover of Forbes magazine, smiling next to Oprah and the Queen.
What up, Oprah?
Oh, every time I close my
what you see, bro?
I see my name in shiny lights.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What up?
A different city every night. Oh,
yeah.
I swear the world better prepare for when I'm a billionaire.
I apologize for that word. But, so what's the first step that a person needs to do, the first step to start working on their money game, no matter where they are, what's the first step that they need to do?
Well, let me recap a little bit about those steps. There are about 7 or 8 points. So if you're listening and if you have a pen and a piece of paper, you may want to start writing a little bit, a few things. First thing is consider to pay yourself first. And that includes God. I believe life is about God, family, and business in that order. So paying yourself means putting yourself and your family before any other demand on your money. And it really means that paying yourself is like a form of self-respect. So you have to deposit a set amount of money each month into some kind of investment program. You'll have to do your research on that. But basically, you want to put money into a money market account. I know it doesn't bear any money, any interest, but it's easy access money, but at the same time, you have to do a few steps to get it. So that would be your emergency money. And it's amazing how money can grow when you don't touch it and you keep putting money in.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand Radio at WHCR. And on the line I have Philip Solovan. Solovan, not the L, no L in there. Solovan.
Solovan.
And we're talking about something that everybody deals with, money.
Right.
Unless you're on an island somewhere. If you're not on an island, you're going to deal with money.
You can eat coconuts and have diarrhea all day. That's fine.
Yep. So you were saying?
Yeah, pay yourself first is the first thing you have to do. Second thing is you have to adjust your priorities, really. If you could write down on a big sheet of paper or something that you can put on your refrigerator where you write down if you make $10 and spend $9 equal happiness. But if you make $10 and spend $11 equal misery, and you look at this every day, it's going to change the way you look at the way you spend money, and it's going to define a little bit more about your wants and needs, something that I will cover a little bit down the road. And as you begin that journey in terms of financial security, remember this point. It's not what you make. It's what you keep. So that's number two. Number three is you have to change your thinking. The way you think about money is everything. Your mindset is a powerful, especially when it comes to money. And that explains why so many people who win a lottery end up losing it all, because they don't have the right way of thinking. See, they have a $20,000 or $30,000 income annual mentality type, and suddenly they get a million. It's not the same mindset. So if you think you don't deserve to be financially secure, you're probably right. So you have to start to ask yourself, do I deserve more? You should say to yourself, I deserve more. I deserve more, and I'll do whatever it takes to deserve more. So again, it's really a mindset. You have to start thinking in a way that people who are a little bit more wealthy than you think. And you may want to ask ideas about other people who think this way and having a higher income than yourself. Because really, when you think of it, you take the 10 closest people of your life that you deal with, and you add up all their income, and you divide it by the number of people. That's pretty much what you make. You know, people think alike. So start looking for people who are in a better position than you and ask them, what should I do? It doesn't hurt to ask. The only wrong question is the question you don't ask. So that's number three, change your thinking. Number four is adjust your lifestyle. As I mentioned about the wants and needs, along with setting priorities come one tough rule in life, and you can't have everything. You have to understand that. You have to make decision, conscious decision about every purchase. So an important concept is to understand wants and need. Do you want to buy a pack of cigarettes, or do you need to buy a pack of cigarettes? So define what does it mean, a need in terms of smoking and smoking away your future. Anyway, you have to deal with those kind of things. A need is something that you have to have, something that you can't do without. You need food, you need shelter, you need utility, you need to pay your bills. It's very difficult to deal with a situation where you have to pay your bill and you don't have life at home. You feel you're totally deprived. So you have to take care of those needs. And if you want to achieve financial independence, you may have to make sacrifices.
All right, so let me ask you. So here comes the challenge,
right?
The what's in your hand challenge. I'm going to put $100 in your hand, and we're going to put you in a city, big city, where you know no one, whether it's Chicago, L.A., Boston, Philly, some big city. $100 in your pocket. You can't get on the phone and do a lifeline and call someone for help. You have to use your what's in your hand, your talent, your abilities, your skills, your gifts, and whatever that city has to offer. How are you going to maneuver with that $100 in your pocket? You have to find a place to live, and you have to eat with that $100. What is Felipe Solovan going to do?
Okay, you're asking me a question on a challenge that I'm not familiar with, but if I have $100 in my hand,
In the city where you know no one, just you, by
yourself. In the city where I know no one. So there are a few variables that I have to take into account. Is how long do I have to stay there? Is it a challenge which is given to me to prove something? How long I have to stay there? And will $100 will be enough to stay 1 day, 2 days, 3 days? So that's what I would look at as a base. And now if I have to stay longer, then I have $100 to keep myself at a certain level, having a certain level of energy so that I can go and look for a job to make more money. So the question is, how long do I have to stay there? And if I have $100 to stay for 1 day, guess what? I'm just going to eat. If I have $100.
No, not 1 day. That's, you're there. You're in the city. And you have to make it on that $100.
I have to make it in that city. Okay. I have no idea, Nick.
Rick,
I'm sorry. I have no idea because I would have to be put in that situation. And based on what I have learned, I know that my attitude will have a lot to do with succeeding. I cannot tell you how I would do it because I do not know. I do not know the city and its infrastructure and how I can get into a situation where I can get help without calling an helpline, like you said.
You could use the resources of the city.
Right. Okay. I can do that. Fine. But I have $100, so I have to do with $100. So until I'm put in that situation, I can't tell you what my experience is, really. But again, it's going to depend pretty much of your attitude in terms of the circumstances. Are the circumstances taking over the way you think, or are you creating the circumstances that's going to help you to get ahead? $100 or $50 is really not a matter of the amount. It's a matter of how you're going to go by doing it. And I can't tell you what it is because I've not experienced it. Sorry about that.
Well, you know, there's a lot of people that are in that situation, have been in that situation, and even have less money in the city. One lady that I met yesterday, she said she had left her husband, and she walked away with 17 cents. I said, wow.
That's a lot. That's a lot not to have.
I know,
but,
right?
But again, we still live in a society where opportunity exists if you are looking for it. Too many times, opportunity knock on the front door, and we don't recognize it. It goes through the back door. We still don't recognize it. And there are people who take it and succeed. So what are you willing to do? It's really the question. I mean, I see immigrants who come in this country. They think that the pavement in New York is made of gold. And they come here totally disoriented, and still, after 2-3 years, become very wealthy. One common denominator that I see is they work really hard. They work really hard. They wake up early in the morning and go very late at night. Thousands and thousands of examples in New York. We can pinpoint them. It's very easy. And then you have people who think, oh, this person is taking my job. What have you done in order to really work hard and deserve to get that job? And I know it's a cheap statement, but I believe that there are some adjustments you need to make. There is something that you have to think about yourself in terms of your self-respect and being convinced that you are worth more than what you think you are. This really the cornerstone of anything that you want to do and achieve in life is knowing that you have more potential than you think you are, and the great blessing for you would be to find somebody who thinks that you are better than what you are, who would really help you to get forward in life.
Give me a success story of something that you've seen a success story that was in pretty challenging situations financially and became a success story.
Story of someone who used to be a teacher in one of those South American countries. I can't remember which one. He works not with me directly, but he came in this country and he had $40, the equivalent of $40. He came in New York, and over 1 or 2 days, the money was gone. So he was more like a beggar in the streets. And then he decided to pick himself up, and to enroll into some kind of community college, to study psychology. And he did succeed in getting a degree, and practicing for 5 years, making about $200,000 a year after 5 years. And 5 years earlier, he was in the street sleeping. If you listen to his testimony, the way he succeeded, you can only understand two words out of three, because his English is not even good. So don't tell me that you can't make money and not even speaking the language, because if you have enough desire, you can do much more than what you think you are able to do.
Why is it important for you to help people improve their money situation? Why is that important for you?
One reason is because I've been there. I've been in a situation where I had no money. I mean, you know the kind of situation where you bang your head on the wall and you make a mark on the wall? That kind of situation. And then I decided that I needed to understand what rich people do. Not that I'm rich by the billionaire standard, but I'm well off. The question is, what it is that I don't know that they know that will make a difference in my life. And I started to read a little bit. I started to talk to people who are successful and try to get some kind of a thread of understanding what are the common component of successful people. And one thing I understood is they know how to adjust their lifestyle based on their needs and their wants. That's the thing I was covering about. They definitely understand the power of saving money with time, because one of the things that we have a tendency to think is sometime in the future I will start. It's always the kind of mindset that we have. We think, you know, when you think about the way a family lives, it's really based on what I would call the theory of decreasing responsibility, whereby when you are young and you have a family, you have a lot of bills to pay. But at the same time, money doesn't wait for you to grow. So time is a very important commodity in our life. And we tend to think that, you know, when the children will be grown, that's when I'll start saving. And then suddenly you realize that you need money to pay for college. So what you do most of the time, you either borrow money or you borrow from the equity of your home. And then you are back to square one in terms of the mortgage and how you're going to be mortgage free. When the children are out of college, it's not that you want to ask them the money back of what you gave them to pay for college. You want them to succeed in life. So you end up really saving nothing, because time has gone by. And you cannot say time out, let's start from the beginning because I really need to save money. It's too late. That's the problem. So we think we have too much time. Or we think we have time. I'm not saying too much. We think we have time to do certain things. Well, we think we need to know more about how to invest before we invest. Sometimes it's true, sometimes it's not. Time doesn't care where you are. Time is time. It's always funny when people say, you know, I need to manage my time. It doesn't make any sense. You can't manage time. You need to do things in a certain period of time so that you get result after a long run. The most powerful principle, even Albert Einstein said, it's compound interest. Compound interest, because you actually capitalize on things you've done in the past, which itself growing even more. You know, I asked one time at somebody, what happened if you improve 1% a year? And he said, well, I will be better, 365% better. I said, no. You are just adding linearly the percentage. It's 1% over 1%, 2% over 3%, 3% over 4%. You'll be thousand over better. But are you willing to take the steps? That's the question.
That's the question.
Yep.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Rick Young, another segment of What's in Your Hand Radio at WHCR 90.3 FM. And in the studio, I have Philip Soovan. Soovan.
Okay, Soovan.
Soovan. Soovan. Okay, Soovan. Okay, there you go. And we're just about at the end.
Right, so I just wanted to conclude with those little point that I was mentioning. And one was, of course, to adjust your lifestyle in terms of your wants and needs. That's number four. Number five is you have to find ways possibly to earn an additional income somewhere. I mean, how much time do we spend? How much time do we waste, really? If we really, when it boils down to adding all the hours where we are active, are there maybe some hours where we really don't do anything that can actually be productive? So finding...
You mean like using what's in your hand?
Well, that too. And also using what's in your hand, meaning what?
Meaning using your talents?
Using your talent.
Using your gifts?
That too. But in terms of generating additional income, maybe you have more time for another part-time. I know it's not the best way to do things, but maybe it's temporary until you get off, get back on your feet. So if your family income is very modest and things are kind of tight and you can't invest even $50 a month, maybe you need to make another $50 a month or a week at least. I wouldn't really, consider making $50 a month and not getting any result into that. But think about the time that you can actually have, which is more productive than, training your thumb on the remote control of your flat TV screen. So earning additional income, that's one area where you can actually consider using your ability to be productive. Because if you can still breathe and you can still be on your feet, talking about people who can do that, then just do it.
But one of the most powerful things that was said today to me, and it's still, I think this is the most powerful thing said, is that the borrower is a slave to the lender.
Again, it goes along with the little paragraph that I ask people to possibly write and put on the refrigerator. If you make $10 and you spend $9, equal happiness. If you spend $10 and spend $11, equal misery. It's all about trying to imprint into your brain things that can be either a matter of giving you more satisfaction or giving you more regret. So the point is, there are two things in life that you have to check as part of the way you're going to feel. There are two boxes in your life. One is the pain of change or the pain of regret. So let me tell you what the pain of change means. It means you may have to do a little sacrifice for a short period of time so that you can get on track to become financially secure. The pain of regret is saying, yeah, I know I need to do it, but I'm not doing it. And then you wake up 20 years down the road and now you are full of regret and your life become a life of explanation why instead of becoming a life of exclamation.
Well, people, they don't like discipline. But the results from discipline is awesome. The things that you get from discipline.
I agree.
It's amazing.
I agree. And that's why never go into gyms, gymnast, you call this, those, it's probably why I don't go there. Place where you train. How do you call this? I have
health clubs.
Yeah, health club. I'm sorry, I had a blank here. Health club. Never go in January because it's too packed. Too many people, you know, they have new resolution to lose weight. They go on January and then it hurts. You know, they do a few exercise and then the next morning all the muscles aches. They say, it's not for me, you know, it's hurting. Again, it's painful to exercise and to have a bodybuilder type of body, but it takes effort, and but we don't like the pain.
So can they come next Saturday? Can they just say they want to come next Saturday?
Sure.
To the Learning Center at 4 West 43rd Street. That's between 5th and 6th Avenue.
Correct.
It's on the first floor. I think it's in Studio B.
Yeah, it's on the ground floor. It's a brown room. It's called the brown room.
The brown room.
Yes. They're actually renovating all this, and so we are kind of in the middle of a ongoing improvement, but it's a great room. We have all the technology to show the videos and conduct a group discussion. So
come on down Saturday, 1 p.m. Right. Starting at 1 p.m. next Saturday, April 13th, and the Learning Center, 4 West 43rd Street.
At 1 o'clock.
At 1 p.m.
1 p.m. Just come 15 minutes before.
Yeah, come a little early. And I want you to come. I'm a part of an event that's going to take place at the Pearl Studios. Write this down, 519 8th Avenue on the 12th floor. That's between 35th and 36th Street, Studio B. That's Thursday, May 2nd. Registration starts at 5:30. There's no charge. 5:30, we're going to go to about 9. And we're going to have guest speakers Dave and Laurie Smith. And you're going to meet Sarah Baslow, who was here on my show who was here Friday, and you're going to meet Michelle Reynolds. They're all going to be there at Pearl Studios, 519 8th Avenue on the 12th floor. That's between 35th and 36th Street in Studio B. It's going to be an amazing event, and I'll be there. You'll see me there. And so, any final word before we leave, Philip?
My final word would be... love yourself in terms of self-respect. Start using the basics and the fundamentals of harmony works in your life. The way you can do it is, of course, attending the program at the Dave Ramsey program, Rick mentioned, at 4 West 43rd on Saturdays at 1 o'clock, or do your research until it makes sense. And until you feel confident that you can go ahead, but also ask other people's opinion to the point where you're going to have a certain ideas of what is right and what is wrong in terms of how you handle money.
All right. This is Rick Young signing off. I'll see you next Friday. Dalton Anderson is in the building. Will be the next voice you'll hear. Money.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
WHCR 90.3 FM in New York, emanating for the campus of City College, located at 160 Compton Avenue in New York City. The program you're about to hear is Morning Praise, the best in traditional, contemporary, and urban gospel music. I'm your host, Dalton Anderson. Good morning to you, Harlem, Tri-State, and our internet family on WHCR.org.
Has been approved by the Holy Spirit for all general listening audiences.
Jesus, have in your name here.
Lift them up and give
church.
WACR 90.3 FM in New York. It's Morning Praise with a man that knows how to wake and bake and shake you right at your gospel beds on a Sunday morning. My name is Dalton Anderson. How are you doing, New York? New York City!
Yeah, 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 yeah. Celebrate.
It's Morning Praise. Every Sunday morning from 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. Nothing but the best in great gospel music.
Oh, oh, celebrate. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The phone number 212-650-6903. 212-650-6903. That's what I'm talking about. I know you're calling in. Hold on for a few moments. Hold on. We're streaming live at WHCR.org. WHCR.org. Let's celebrate. That's what I'm talking about. It's all great gospel music, huh? Andre Crouchin. It's all around the world. Featuring Chaka Khan. Mm-hmm. And Sheila E. on the cymbalas. Hey. It's Morning Praise. On WHCR 90.3 FM. Bring it, Dalton.
We will never change.